We're back to the simulator to start to learn about one particular kind of designed experiment. This is the 2 to the k factorial experiment. Now, the key to that is down here in this matrix. And it's set up for 8 input variables. I've stripped out 5 of them so that we can have a simple example. And what we have here is a matrix of minus 1s and 1s. And if you'll look down this column, I've got minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, and so on down. And here I've got minus 1 twice, and then plus 1 twice, and then I've got minus 1 4 times, and plus 1 4 times. Okay. In a 2 to the k factorial, we use 2 states for each input variable, a high and a low. And minus 1 represents the low, and plus 1 represents the high. So what this says is that I'm going to put variables A, B, and C in their low state, and then I'm going to measure the output, which is going to be my Y. Then I'm going to put A in the high state and B and C in the low state, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to measure Y. Well, if you think about it a little bit, if you've got 2 states per variable and 3 variables, then the maximum number of combinations that you, unique combinations that you can make is 2 to the third power, or 8. So you notice I've got a set of 8 combinations, unique combinations of input variables here. And so this is a full factorial. That is that I'm using all possible combinations. There's some nice fractional designs, and we'll get to those in due course. But for right now, this is the one we want to look at. It's very illuminating. Now, up here in my settings, I can set up a low and a high for each of the 8 variables. Well, I don't have to worry about D through H, and I don't have to worry about Y for the moment. And I can set my nominal value, and then the factor I want that moved by to create my low and my high. So 300 plus 4 is 304, and 300 minus 4 is 296. So this is my high value, this is my low value. Here's my high for B, and my low, and my high, and my low. Now, if we look over in this matrix, I can just ignore D through H, because I've set you up a simple 3-factor design. This is the same thing as this matrix. Here we go. Low, high, low, high. And if you look over here, low, low, high, high. And then 4 lows and 4 highs. So these two are the same thing, except this is in coded units and this is in native units. Okay? So the strategy then is I'm going to put my A variable at 296, my B variable at 50, and my C variable at 1.7, take an observation. The nice thing about this structure is that it's a very robust structure, and it will allow you to simultaneously test easily up to 5 variables and all of their possible interactions for the same number of observations that it takes to do a t-test. Now, when we get above 5 variables, there are some other things that we like to do, but 2, 3, 4, 5 variables, a full factorial 2 to the k design is an excellent choice.